And God created great whales, and every living creature that moveth, which the waters brought forth abundantly, after their kind, and every winged fowl after his kind, and God saw that it was good. Genesis 1 verse 21. And God created great whales, which the Targums of Jonathan and Jarki interpret of the Leviathan and its mate, concerning which the Jews have many fabulous things. Large fishes are undoubtedly meant, and the whale being of the largest sort, the word is so rendered. Aelianus, from various writers, relates many things of the extraordinary size of whales, of one in the Indian Sea 5 times bigger than the largest elephant, one of its ribs being 20 cubits, from Theocles, of one that was larger than a galley with 3 oars, and from one Secretus and Orthagoras, of one that was half a furlong in length, and Pliny speaks of one sort called the Balaena, and of one of them in the Indian Sea, that took up 4 aces of land, and so Salinas, and from Juba, he relates there were whales that were 600 feet in length, and 360 in breadth, but whales in common are but about 50, 70, 80, or at most 100 feet. Some interpret these of crocodiles, see Ezekiel 29 verse 3, some of which are 20, some 30, and some have been said to be 100 feet long. The word is sometimes used of dragons, and, if it has the sense here, must be meant of dragons in the sea, or sea serpents, Leviathan the piercing serpent, and Leviathan the crooked serpent, Isaiah 27 verse 1, so the Jews, and such as the Bishop of Bergen speaks of as in the northern seas of 100 fathom long, or 600 English feet. And who also gives an account of a sea monster of an enormous and incredible size, that sometimes appears like an island at a great distance, called Kraken, now because creatures of such a prodigious size were formed out of the waters, which seemed so very unfit to produce them, therefore the same word is here made use of, as is in the creation of the heaven and the earth out of nothing, Genesis 1 verse 1, because this production, though not out of nothing, yet was an extraordinary instance of almighty power. And every living creature that moveth, which the waters brought forth abundantly after their kind. That is, every living creature that swims in the waters of the great sea, or in rivers, whose kinds are many, and their numbers not to be reckoned, see Gill on Genesis 1 verse 20. And every winged fowl after his kind. Every fowl, and the various sorts of them that fly in the air, these were all created by God, or produced out of the water and out of the earth by his wonderful power. And God saw that it was good. Or foresaw that those creatures he made in the waters and in the air would serve to display the glory of his perfections, and be very useful and beneficial to man, he designed to create. Some of the creatures described by the ancients must refer to animals that are now extinct. Some of these may have been very large dinosaurs. Ed.